And then later we see him all aged up, like you saw in the game, right? He
Yeah.
has a beard now, he's
Oh,
bigger.
yeah.
That because that he after that he traveled to another land in Norse mythology, where he found this woman that isn't that where he found this woman named Laufey.
Laufey.
Yeah, she found this woman called Laufey. She's a giant from that. Listen that.
Okay,
That
she's a giant.
listen that.
Okay.
In Norse mythology, that listen that. In Norse mythology, there are nine realms. That there are nine realms.
Okay.
There's Midgard, our mainland. There's I don't really remember everything else, but there's Muspelheim, the land of fire. That listen that. There's Muspelheim, the land of like lava, fire, and everything. There's Svartalfheim, the land of the dwarves.
Dwarves?
Yeah, dwarves. There's a realm, I forgot its name, but it's called like Lightheim or something, where it's the land of the elves. Like there's dark elves and light elves and stuff. And then there's Asgard. Asgard, that listen.
Asgard,
Asgard is one of the realms too. And then there's Jotunheim, the land of the giants. That
Oh,
Jotun,
okay.
that listen that. Jotunheim is the land of the giants. And in Norse mythology lore, the giants are the one that crafted and built everything in Midgard. They're the ones that aided humanity and stuff.
Okay.
And in Asgard, you know the gods like Thor, Odin, they're called Aesir gods. Aesir gods.
Easier.
Yeah, the A-E-S-I-R. Yeah,
Okay.
they're called Aesir gods. They're the evil ones. They hate the giants because in God of War, they're the ones that eliminated the whole Jotunheim realm.
All
That
right.
listen, listen. The Aesir gods in Asgard, in God of War, they killed all the giants in Jotunheim. Every single one.
Oh.
Yeah, all the giants. Except for there's this other giant called Tyr. That Tyr. Listen to that. There's this other giant called Tyr, Tyr. He's also like the weapons craftsman or something. Because in Midgard, that listen to that. In Midgard, there's like this big lake, and in the middle of that lake, there's like a temple, and surrounding that temple on the outer lake, that like on the outer lake, there are nine towers. There are nine towers representing the nine realms. And the temple in the middle of the big lake has a big bridge. That listen to that. The temple in the middle of the big lake has a big bridge. And inside the temple, that's where you can actually travel to different realms.
Inside the
Yeah,
temple.
because in the temple there's this what big white tree or something. That listen to that. In the middle of the temple, inside that, listen, there's this big white tree that
White tree.
Yeah, with where you need to require some sort of stone. And when you put it in, there's a little map. That listen that that there's a little map,
Map.
yeah, inside of the big white tree that shows like the outside of the temple, like the nine towers in the map, the big temple, and then the bridge. You can actually rotate it and you can actually rotate the bridge on the map. And when it rotates, it also rotates the big bridge outside the temple. Yeah,
Really?
so that. So when you like rotate the bridge to point at a certain tower, the bridge outside the temple will also rotate as well. And it will, if you want to go to Jotunheim, that is that
Is the name is
the land of the giants, Jotunheim.
okay.
And if you
Wait,
want,
I have a question.
yeah.
You mean the Ragnarok, Thor,
Yeah.
and Greek mythology?
Yeah.
And the God of War,
Yeah.
they're all connected.
Yeah, they're all connected. But Norse is like a separate. It's like a.
Norse, you mean Norse
Yeah,
mythology?
it's like the mythology of Vikings. Something like that. Norse
Ah,
mythology is
okay.
the mythology of Vikings.
Okay, so Thor and Kratos,
Yeah.
they belong to Norse mythology?
Kratos was born in Greek, but he just moved to Norse because he lived throughout the years. So yeah, so inside the temple, if you want to go to a certain realm, remember I said there are nine towers surrounding the lake that represent the nine realms. If you want to go to like for example Niflheim, it's a different realm. You have to rotate the bridge in that map to point at the Niflheim Tower, and it will also rotate the bridge outside of the tower, and it will point at the Tower of Niflheim. And after that, you can go outside the temple and walk inside the gate. Listen to that.
Yeah, yeah.
You can go outside the temple and walk inside the gate where you can enter that realm. I forgot to mention, there's also the realm called Helheim. That
Helheim?
Yeah, it's like the underworld of Norse mythology.
Because
you know, our hell here is fire. Like, you know that our hell represented here is like all fire and lava.
Yeah.
You know, in Norse mythology, Helheim is represented with a cold land.
Cold land?
Yeah, frozen. Everything, like with the souls walking, all freezing and stuff.
Okay.
So, And I think there's also another realm called Valhalla. That Valhalla is like the land, it's kind of like the heaven of Norse mythology.
Okay.
Where it's guided by these female warriors called Valkyries.
Mm-hmm.
That Valhalla is like the land of the noble. That, listen to that.
It's yeah, like, wait. What? How about Thor?
Asgard. He's in Asgard.
Yeah, is he part of the Greek?
No, Norse.
Ah, Norse.
Yeah.
Thor?
Yeah, because...
Loki?
Yeah, they're all Norse.
Ah, they're all Norse.
Yeah, and Norse is a separate land from Greek, because Greek is a place, you know? But Norse is different, because they speak Viking language there.
Okay.
So after that, Valhalla is the land of like the those who are noble after they die.
Mm-hmm.
And it's rumored in Norse mythology that if a noble person dies, female warriors called Valkyries will come in and escort them to Valhalla. It's like the land of clouds and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So after that, the lore is that, remember Jotunheim?
Mm-hmm.
The land of the giants that Thor and the others invaded to kill all the giants.
Mm-hmm.
You know, after that happened, Tyr, you know Tyr, right? The one, craftsman, the one who built the temple to travel all to the different realms?
Yeah.
Listen, remember Tyr? The one who built the temple to travel all the different realms, that?
Yeah.
That, after his realm got annihilated, he actually removed the Jotunheim Tower so that no one could ever go to the land of the giants anymore. And you want to know where he hid it?
Where?
Listen to that. Before you transfer to a... Are you listening?
Yeah.
Before you transfer to a realm, when you already select a realm you want to go to, and you walk through the bridge to get there,
mm-hmm.
when you're inside... Listen to that. When you're inside the realm... Not yet. When you're, like, inside of the tower that leads to the realm,
yeah.
you are first transported to, like, this galaxy
mm-hmm.
type... that like this galaxy-type realm,
mm-hmm.
where you are walking along... tree branches.
Mm-hmm.
Listen, that. Before you enter a realm, you have to go through inside the tower. And when you're inside the tower, you have to walk through this galaxy type realm
mm-hmm.
where there's like stars, like galaxy and stuff. And you're walking along white tree branches.
Mm-hmm.
I think these tree branches are also the same scene as in the middle of the tower
mm-hmm.
where you like change the realm. So after that, when you're walking along like the tree branches,
mm-hmm.
you have to wait for like a little portal to come out so that you can enter the realm.
Mm-hmm.
And you don't know where Tyr hid that.
Where?
You don't know where Tyr hid the Tower of Jotunheim so that no one could ever...
Where?
He hid it inside of that realm. I forgot what it's called. I think it was called like the Realm of All Realms. I don't remember. It's like
mm-hmm.
a realm between realms.
Mm-hmm.
You know what that means?
Mm-hmm.
Realm between realms? That, you know what that means?
What?
It's like a world in between all the other worlds. Like where it's like the world connected where it leads to the other worlds.
Okay.
That when you want to transport, you have to go through that realm first.
Mm-hmm.
And then you have to find which way leads to that realm you want to go to. The realm between realms, it's like the realm between realms. It's like, between realms is like the main realm. Like, you know, like, for example, there's Asgard, Midgard, and the other realms, like Jotunheim.
Mm-hmm.
The realm between realms is the one between all of that, that connects all those realms together.
Yeah.
And that's where you can go to the realms. It's like, I don't know how to explain it, but it's something like, the realm between realms is kind of like a train system. Where you know that, like for example, you know those like mechanisms, like there's like, if you put the train in the middle, it can like rotate.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
There's like, if you put the train in the middle of a railroad, there's like a mechanism that can rotate and it can choose its different.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
you know, like okay. A train that rotates and it can choose its different places.
Yeah.
It's kind of like that. The realm between realms is kind of like that, with the other rails leading to the different realms.
Oh, okay.
So when you once you select the tower and you enter that tower, you are sent there first, the realm between realms, where you have to find your way to that realm.
Mm-hmm.
And Tyr, that listen, and Tyr hid the tower in that realm.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
He hid the tower in the realm between realms, somewhere no one would figure out. And you wanna know where he hid it so none of the gods would find it?
Where?
It's very risky because you need a runestone that will keep you alive because you have to do something very dangerous. Remember I said
before you can get it?
Yeah, yeah, you wanna know, like, remember we were walking on like white tree branches, right?
Yeah.
And we're like in some sort of space world, right?
Mm-hmm.
Do you know, for you to get to where Tyr hit the tower, you have to jump off that tree to the void.
Oh, it's so risky.
Yeah, remember I said it's like a space realm. Like, it's like emptiness. It's kind of like a void with stars, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Remember space? Like,
yeah,
it's all like purple lighting with stars around.
Yeah.
It's like a void with only you standing on top of a white tree in the middle.
Mm-hmm.
You have to, like, jump off it. And then you have to land on a different realm below that realm. Remember, the realm between realms, it's like, remember, the name, realm between realms.
Yeah.
It's like the main living source of the realms, remember?
Yeah, yeah.
And it's like represented as a big white tree in the middle of space. Something like that. That's how it's, that's how it's represented. The realm between realms is represented by a big white tree in the middle of space. Like some sort of space.
Oh.
And since you're in space, you can literally jump off, right? You can jump off that tree. But it's risky because you might get evaporated. Because, you know, if you go beyond that void, you will never come back, you know?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But so you need a specific runestone that will keep you alive, Dad.
Mm-hmm.
So when you have a runestone, you can actually jump off.
Oh, what, a runestone?
It's like a stone with like a little spell in it.
Okay.
So when you absorb that stone, you can jump off and survive.
Okay.
And that's where Tyr hit that tower, so none of the gods would get there. And remember,
well, what will happen if those gods will
they
get
will
there?
Destroy all Jotunheim. Even though it's annihilated, Tyr still cannot let the gods see the knowledge. Because you wanna know why? Giants have this special ability to see the future still.
Oh, that's why.
So Tyr saw that. Tyr saw the future. And you wanna know what else that? They write the future in the walls of their...
The giants?
Yeah, like in Jotunheim, when you get there, there's like a little mountain that humans can walk through.
Mm-hmm.
And in that mountain, in the walls, there are like writings showing... They're like illustrations showing the future.
Mm-hmm.
Because here's a little spoiler. In the end of the game, Kratos and Atreus, when they go to Jotunheim, they literally see all their journey written... In the walls.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't that?
Okay.
At the end of the game, when Kratos and his son enter the mountain, and they see all the illustrations there of the future.
Yeah.
All the illustrations are the journey they just went through.
Wow.
Yeah, Like, all the illustrations, the future, remember they can see the future?
Yeah.
All of it are from the journeys they were in the game.
Yeah.
Like, going through all the journeys, it's all written there already.
Wow.
Because remember Laufey, the wife of Kratos I talked about?
Yeah.
That remember the female giant that I talked about named Laufey, the one that Kratos found?
Yeah.
She saw the future and she wrote all that.
Oh.
That so after Kratos married Laufey, they had the child, Atreus, the boy there.
In the game?
Yeah, Atreus.
Atreus.
And Kratos, And Kratos, this is the time where he was wise. That where he has matured from his ruthless warlord thing. He wants to be a good father, something like that.
Okay.
But he doesn't want his son to end up like him. Like, you know, like all ruthless and stuff.
Okay.
So it's always Laufey, the mother, that raised Atreus because Kratos doesn't want to influence Atreus. So Laufey, she passed away. And her last wish for Kratos and Atreus was to spread her ashes to the highest peak in all the realms. The highest...
Why?
It's like a final wish.
Okay.
Like that. You know, like when you burn a corpse, there are ashes?
Yes.
She wants them to spread her ashes on the highest peak in all the realms. And so they will do that just that. And after she passed away, Kratos then took the responsibility of raising and training Atreus. First, mm-hmm. teaching him how to use a bow and hunting
okay.
and stuff, like, you know, hunting
yeah,
and
yeah,
stuff.
Yeah.
And so after that, after they were done hunting, Atreus is a little, what is it? He's a little spoiled. That isn't it. That isn't it.
Atreus?
He's a little, like, because he's not really spoiled, but he's just, like, frustrated because Kratos never pays any attention to him. That
okay.
he's not spoiled, he's just like angry because Kratos, even though he never raised him much, he's still suddenly taking responsibility and then
okay.
like training him to be stronger and stuff.
Okay.
But Laufey was the one who's been raising him to be, like, you know, normal.
Mm.
But Kratos wanted him to be stronger because he knows the road up ahead.
Mm.
So after they went home, doesn't it? After they went home,
yeah.
Dad, suddenly, there was a knock at their door. That there was a knock at their door, and someone was yelling to come out.
Mm-hmm.
And when so Kratos hid Atreus under their cabin. Like,
mm-hmm.
they live in a little cabin
yeah.
in the woods. And he hid Atreus under there. And when he opened it, and when Kratos opened the door, he saw this skinny-looking man with a brown beard,
mm-hmm.
with blue tattoos.
Mm-hmm.
That there's this, like, skinny-looking man, no shirt, like, just all pants.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
With blue tattoos all around him,
mm.
He then introduced himself as Baldur. That
mm.
Baldur is the Norse mythology brother of Thor. Loki is actually not the brother of Thor; it's the Baldur.
Oh really?
Yeah, in Marvel, Loki is the brother of Thor, but in Norse mythology, Loki is not Thor's brother.
So you mean Marvel? They just
yeah.
made up story.
Yeah.
Okay, it's not in the Norse mythology.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. It's on.
Ah,
yeah.
Okay.
Then, so Baldur. He's like the...
Baldur's the brother of...
Yeah, the Norse brother of Thor.
Thor. Not Loki.
Yeah. And in Norse mythology, Baldur, he... What is it? He was known to be the god who cannot feel anything.
Baldur?
Yeah, he cannot feel anything. Like, no pain, no... he cannot taste, he cannot feel,
really?
Like, no pain at all.
Mm.
Like, he's almost like an immortal god
okay.
because he cannot feel anything.
Okay.
And that he cannot taste. And Baldur, he hated that. Because his mother, that listen that.
Yeah.
His mother, Freya.
The mother of Kratos?
No, Baldur.
Baldur.
His mother, Freya, and the former wife of Odin, that Freya.
Yeah.
She used to be a Valkyrie.
Valkyrie.
Yeah, remember, like, the female warriors that, you know, they're, like,
yeah, yeah, yeah.
strong. She used to be a Valkyrie, but she's also a witch, that.
Mm-hmm.
And she was afraid that her son would die, that she cursed Baldur to not feel anything.
Mm.
Yeah, that is that.
Wait. Something came in my mind.
Mm-hmm.
What's the connection of Zeus in the Greek mythology of Kratos?
Zeus is the father of Kratos.
In Greek mythology?
In Greek mythology, he's not. Kratos was actually the... embodiment of power and strength in Greek mythology. He had no relationship with Zeus.
Yeah.
But Kratos was just like his errand boy in Greek mythology. You remember
okay.
I talked about the guy who in Greek mythology who took a fire from Olympus and tried to help humanity?
Yeah,
remember
yeah,
that?
Yeah, yeah.
And then he got chained up and fed and was like and the bed the bird was like eating him,
mm-hmm.
his like guts out.
Yeah.
In Greek mythology, Kratos was the one who chained him up in order by Zeus.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, Kratos was the one who chained him up in order from by order from Zeus. But in the game he didn't because he was the son of Zeus.
Okay.
Remember Baldur?
Mm-hmm.
That his mother was afraid that he would die, that she wanted him to not feel anything. So he so Freya cursed him to not feel anything. And Baldur hated that. He hated not being able to feel anything,
mm-hmm.
that he wanted to kill Freya.
Okay.
So after that, Kratos and Baldur, they were like fighting.
Mm.
And in the middle of their fight, they were like splitting land. Like in the middle of
mm.
their fight, they were like splitting the land and stuff.
Yeah.
And that. And Kratos, remember, he's the god of war, right?
Mm-hmm.
He's really strong.
Kratos.
Like, yeah, really strong. Did you know, in the game, remember the tower I talked about?
Yeah.
The one that you can transfer.
Mm-hmm.
Remember the tower I talked about where you can transfer between realms?
Mm-hmm.
That?
Yeah.
Do you know, in the game, he managed to flip the tower. Right. Like not the whole thing, like just the like just the big, like just the spinnable part.
Okay.
The big spinnable part. He flipped the whole thing. That he even like in the middle of the fight of Baldur, he even broke like this big stone pillar or something. It's not really a pillar, but it's just like this like land thing or something.
Is Baldur strong?
Yeah, he's also strong. Mm-hmm. Like in the before he fought, Baldur actually punched him. And then Kratos was sent flying. Like,
oh, he's, oh,
yeah. So
yeah,
and in the and after the fight, Kratos, he was punching this big like rock, and then he was like punching it so that he would be able to lift it, and he crushed it on Baldur.
Mm-hmm.
But Baldur, he wasn't dead. As Kratos was walking away, Baldur, like he lifted that thing up and threw it at Kratos. But Kratos, like, he also installed the shield, which can open, and he, like, broke it.
Mm-hmm.
And after that, they kept on fighting. And Baldur, remember, I said he can't die because he's immortal, right? He can't feel anything.
Yeah, yeah.
Dead.
How did you defeat him?
Well, at the end of the game, when we see Baldur's mother, dead, Baldur actually has a weakness that... There's this thing called the mistletoe. You know mistletoe, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know mistletoe, right?
Mm-hmm.
Atreus had a mistletoe tied to an arrow. Atreus had this some sort of mistletoe attached to the string of his bow.
Mm-hmm.
That when Baldur grabbed Atreus, his hand actually accidentally touched that mistletoe, and it removed the curse from him.
Oh.
He was able to feel everything. He finally was able to feel the cold. Mm. He was finally able to feel pain and stuff.
Okay.
And Freya was really mad about that. Like because the mistletoe was the only weakness.
Mm.
So after that, they managed to kill Baldur. There's this cycle in the game that there's this little cycle in the game where it's always something like the sons who always kill their fathers or mothers, because remember in God of War, Kratos killed Zeus. Kratos killed Zeus out of vengeance, and in God of War 4, Baldur was about to kill his mother out of vengeance. But Kratos, before Baldur killed Kratos, and before Baldur killed his mother, his mother is like really loving. She really loves her son despite what he does, so she allowed Baldur to kill her. But before Baldur was about to kill her, Kratos stopped Baldur, and he snapped his neck. And then before he said that, he said, the cycle ends here. And he killed, because Kratos said there's a cycle where the children would always kill their parents. Remember, Kratos killed Zeus out of vengeance, and when Baldur was about to kill his mother out of vengeance, Kratos said the cycle ends here, so he killed him instead, which instead made Freya swear vengeance upon Kratos. Freya then swore vengeance on Kratos. And said that she would make sure to kill him after he killed her son. I also forgot to mention that in the middle of the game, we actually get to meet Thor's sons.
Thor?
Yeah, he has Norse mythology sons called Magni and Modi.
Well, by the way, is Thor a hero? He's a hero in the Marvel movies.
No, in Norse, he's not.
What do you mean?
They're like destruction. They're like... In Norse, they're like the destructors of Norse.
They're bad?
Yeah, they're like warlords in Norse mythology. Odin is Odin. He actually lied. Odin in Norse mythology, he actually lied and tricked just to become the all-knowing, the all-knowing father of Norse mythology. Odin actually tricked and lied. Odin actually tricked and lied to people, lied and tricked his way into becoming the All-Father, Odin, in Norse mythology.
Mm-hmm.
He didn't gain his knowledge from, anything. He actually lied and tricked his way into getting it. Because the true smartest man alive in Norse mythology, is a man named Mimir. That
Mimir.
Yeah, Mimir is like he has all the knowledge in the world in Norse mythology, and Odin is the one getting his knowledge from Mimir.
Mm-hmm.
That Odin actually trapped Mimir in a tree. Now listen, that Odin actually trapped Mimir in a tree with only his head popping out, and Mimir, he's the one only talking, and Mimir, he's a neutral god or something. So you don't know how Kratos got Mimir. Freed Mimir and like borrowed his knowledge.
Yeah,
Mimir is immortal also because he's a god and he only has one eye.
Okay.
And that Mimir's
in the middle?
Yeah, no, in the left.
Okay.
That Mimir, he's special because he has two eyes. Now listen, that Mimir has two special eyes that are able to open realms at will.
Oh.
That he has two special eyes that are able to open realms at will, and Odin took one of his eyes so that he won't be able to escape. That
escape?
Yeah, so escape to another realm because he can open realms at will. Like he can go to Jotunheim at will. He can go to Asgard at will. So Odin took one of his eyes so that he won't be able to to move. And Odin hid his eye inside of a statue of Thor in the temple.
Mm-hmm.
Mimir, you wanna know how Kratos got him out? Mimir told Kratos to chop his head off and carry it along with them.
Oh, really?
Yeah, but Mimir, he can't die, so they just did it. They took the head and then they hang the head over here and then they journey as he like talks and stuff.
Okay.
He's like a really funny character. He's like a funny character. He just like talks in the middle of stuff. Remember, because he's like the all-knowing guy.
Yeah.
So after that remember Magni and Modi, the sons of Thor?
Mm-hmm.
Magni wields this big sword made out of lightning,
mm-hmm.
where like he can attack people with it, and Modi has a shield and this little like mace or something out of lightning. And Thor actually Kratos and his son Atreus accidentally bumped into Magni and Modi, and they had no choice but to kill them. Magni, he's like the special child of Thor. He's like the favorite. And Modi, he's like the brother that wants to be good. He wants to be acknowledged by his father, Modi. Modi is like the son of Thor that wants to be acknowledged. He's like not really all special, but he wants to be acknowledged and stuff. And Magni is like the favorite child, something like that. After Kratos killed Magni, Modi ran away to warn his father, but his father was mad that he beat Modi up. Thor was mad that he beat Modi, his son, up, and sent him back dead. And when they returned, Modi was all like beaten up. And at the time, Kratos revealed to Atreus that Atreus is a god, because remember, Atreus is the son of Kratos, god of war. Which then made Atreus all arrogant. Remember the son? When Atreus heard he was a god, he became arrogant. He became rash. He became insolent. That so Atreus killed Modi out of power complex. And Kratos, he was really mad at Atreus, so he like scolded him and stuff. And that it was revealed that I also forgot to mention this. Did you know in Norse mythology, there's this giant snake that surrounds the earth.
In Norse mythology?
Yeah, it's called the World Serpent. It's like this, that there's this serpent called the World Serpent. It's like a very big serpent that surrounds the earth with a tail.
Mm-hmm.
And its head only lies within Midgard. Its head lies in Midgard. Like, it like surrounds the earth to bite its tail, but its head is like, its head is found in Midgard. And here's the thing, it's a friendly giant.
Mm-hmm.
That the World Serpent is also from Jotunheim, remember the land of the giants?
Yeah.
And his name is called the Jormungandr. That Jormungandr means World Serpent in Norse mythology. Or, I forgot what it's called, I think it's Old Norse, Elder Fudar. The Jormungandr, that's the name of the World Serpent. So the World Serpent, he's friendly. Like, he surrounds the earth and stuff.
Yeah.
But he's really friendly. But he speaks in Old Norse, so not many people can understand him. That only Mimir can talk to the World Serpent, because remember, he's the all-knowing character, right?
Yeah.
And that here's the thing, that the Jormungandr actually hates Thor. That remember Jormungandr, he can see the future, right? Because he's a giant.
Yeah.
And he hates Thor because they constantly battle all the time. And it was said in Ragnarok. Remember I said Ragnarok? But listen.
Yeah, Ragnarok is...
Yeah, like the world ending.
Okay.
Something like that. Ragnarok is when the gods and the giants go to war. Something like that. So the Jormungandr saw that in Ragnarok, him and Thor would actually battle. They would actually fight and stuff that.
Mm.
So, yeah, that. And the Jormungandr, he was so mad, he ate the statue of Thor in which Mimir's eye was hidden in.
Oh, okay.
So the way we had to get the eye back is we had to go inside
the snake.
Yeah. We had to go inside the snake and get it back.
Okay.
So after that, it was revealed at the end of the game.
Kids are making damage, I mean, towel and